excitement is growing here. I hope that we're going back and forth to the special camera that has this eclipse, and I've got to put my glasses on to witness this. We've just gone completely dark, at least about the way we see it here. Oh, no, still a sliver left. Is that the diamond ring? Would that be the diamond ring, perhaps? Just a sliver left. And a little more. There it is! We have reached totality here on the Orion coastline. Total eclipse of the sun.
Just an incredible sight, Rob. We're looking at the corona of the sun, the atmosphere of the sun.
It is incredibly dark. It looks like night is falling. The clouds certainly exacerbating that, but this is beyond twilight. It's a spooky, spooky experience. What do you have to say? What does it feel like?
We came from Los Angeles just to see this with my nephews. We drove all the way from Los Angeles.
Drove here from Los Angeles. Yeah. That is commitment, baby. Welcome to the Oregon coastline. How's it feeling right now seeing your first eclipse?
It's amazing. I love it.
Wow. And we need the lights to see all this. We need the lights. I got to check it out one more time, David. Oh my, it is just absolutely spectacular. Look how dark it is, how quiet it is. The air is still. This is like being in the eye of a hurricane. It is spooky. It is spiritual.
I'm going to tell you, Rob, America is watching this
surreal.
With you.
It's amazing.
And when you see the corona around the sun there, Rob, the atmosphere of the sun, talk us through the science of that. I mean, that's hotter than the sun itself. It's millions and millions of degrees Fahrenheit.
It's, you know, you're talking about, yeah, thousands of degrees Fahrenheit, but what we're seeing right now is the corona, the outer atmosphere of the sun, which we don't get to see any other time. This is why scientists are launching balloons. This is why they got their telescopes out. This is why they're so jazzed about this, because we're able to see things that we don't normally see, with the exception of the eclipse. Yeah, exactly. So you said there's something coming out from it. It's almost like you can see some solar flares coming out. Bailey's beads is something we saw earlier. You know, the moon is not completely smooth, so we're seeing some of the outer edges of the sun come through those valleys and over those mountains, and that's why you see that kind of this star effect now. And different colors are happening right now. It's unbelievable. Oh, the diamond ring! We're starting to see it. We're starting to get out of totality now, David. That was our 2 minutes of ecstasy, quite honestly. Unbelievable.
Yeah, this is extraordinary. To let people know at home how we're pulling this off with our photographers. Yeah, Rob, I just want to let folks at home know how we're pulling off the technology of this. You know, the photographers operating these cameras have to slide in a lens, if you will, into the camera to shoot it up at the beginning of it and at the end. But during totality, they can actually pull that out. So that's why you're seeing some of the shifting shades there on your screen. But Rob, now we're now seeing on the other side here what happens. It's almost the exact reverse. And you talked about those Bailey's beads shining down, coming through the valleys. That's named after Francis Bailey, who first figured out what that was.
Exactly. I mean, you know, so much of science, the terms and names that we rattle off are pioneers that discovered them or were in some process out there making things happen. Now the sun's coming out. It's getting brighter. It's getting a little bit warmer. It's hard to describe what it's like. David, the rest of America is going to experience it now, fast and furiously. Back to you.
In fact, they are right now. Let's go to Matters, Oregon, where Matt Gutman is standing by. Remember, Matt was just under blazing sun a moment ago. Matt, talk us through it.
It's hard to. I'm almost speechless. The crowd here is absolutely ecstatic. I'm going to have our cameraman, Glenn, turn down the lights. You actually get a sense of how. Turn it off, Glenn. Let's see how dark it really is. It's pitch black here. This is the most incredible thing I've ever seen. Right now, we're looking at the corona that's a million degrees, so much hotter than the surface of the sun, just a few, about 6,000 degrees. You can see it right there. You guys, I'm going to come back to our folks here. I mean, you guys drove 9 hours.
Oh, my God.
No, this is the second most beautiful thing I've seen in my life.
Is that the first?
Well, I was thinking this one here, you know.
Right there. Did you notice that? That is wisdom at work. I want to bring you over here to a friend of mine I've met. Aria goes to... This is spectacular. Aria studies astrophysics at Pomona College. Aria! She drove here from Boston, David. Drove a car from Boston. That's 3,000 miles.
Aria! Hi, Aria!
is that the temperature has gone down substantially. There's so much less radiation here bouncing up and heating us up, and it's actually chilly. Folks are in their sweatshirts.
We had sweaters because we knew it was going to drop something crazy over here, and so now we're warm and fine, right, Carmen?
Yeah.
Hey, Carmen.
Wow, this is a spectacular sight, David. This is something that so many people didn't expect to see. There are lights in the distance. There have been jets flying right by the corona. There are airplanes in the sky. That must be an incredible sight. Just beyond the teepees, you can see them. And this is lasting for 2 minutes and 4 seconds because we are right in the crosshairs of that totality. It is happening right here. And you can hear the cheers from the crowd as people watch that corona just radiate out. Now, it might have been clearer had we not had those forest fires nearby, but still, that is a pretty exceptional sight that so many people here didn't expect to see. We have folks with their telescopes out here. I'm going to try not to interrupt them. He doesn't want to be interrupted. What do you guys think?
This is pretty cool. It looks like it's nighttime. It's like a sunset, like, all around. It's pretty cool.
And what's astounding is that it continues. Now we're getting the diamond ring effect right now. The sun is slowly being taken out of the shadow as the light increases markedly. You can see it's like someone shining a spotlight on this field. There are thousands of people here. David, 100,000 people just in this part of Oregon outside of Madras, feasting their eyes on a spectacle that many of us will never get to see again. Back to you, David. This is a pretty remarkable sight here.
Just incredible. 10:22 Pacific time there. You're looking live at Madras, Oregon. That's Matt Gutman and the team. And let's go back to that shot if we could. We literally saw it go dark there for about 2 minutes' time. That was their max totality. Now the sun has come back out. We are less than 10 minutes away from our next moment of max totality in this country, so we're going to take a break. The Great American Eclipse, our coverage continues live right here on ABC, right after the break. We'll be back.